Praise the Lord, children. எல்லோரும் எப்படி இருக்கீங்க? ஐ ஹோப் எவ்ரி ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்டேயிங் சேஃப் அண்ட் ஐ இன் குட் ஹெல்த். ஸோ வி மீட் அகெயின் ஃபார் பைபிள் மெடிடேஷன் டுடே. ஸோ பிஃபோர் வி ஸ்டார்ட், லெட்ஸ் ப்ரே. ஜெபிப்போம். ஹெவன்லி ஃபாதர், வி வாண்ட் டு தேங்க் யூ ஃபார் திஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல் டைம் தட் ஹவ் கிவன் அஸ். ஃபாதர், வி வாண்ட் டு தேங்க் யூ ஃபார் தி சில்ட்ரன் ஃபார் லிஸனிங் டு திஸ் வீடியோ. லார்ட் ஃபாதர், லார்ட் ஐ ப்ரே தி பிளஸ் தம் இன் ஜீசஸ் நேம். லார்ட் ஜீசஸ் ஃபாதர், எஸ்பெஷலி டுடே அஸ் வி லேர்ன் அபவுட் ரைச்சஸ்னஸ், லார்ட் ஃபாதர், ஓப்பன் அவர் ஹார்ட்ஸ், அவர் மைண்ட்ஸ், அவர் இயர்ஸ், தட் வி வில் பி ஏபிள் டு ஹியர் யுவர் வாய்ஸ் அண்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். லார்ட் ஜீசஸ் ஃபாதர், வி கமிட் த லெசன்ஸ் ஃபுல்லி அண்ட் யுவர் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் வி ஹம்பலி ஆஸ்க் ஆல் திஸ் இன் ஜீசஸ் நேம். ஆமென். ஓகே சில்ட்ரன், ஆர் யூ ஆல் ரெடி?
How can we become righteous if all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, as it says in Romans 3:23? How can we obtain this righteousness to receive eternal life? Romans 5:17 says, "For if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ." This righteousness is a gift that all of us may have if we wanted it. And once we receive this gift of righteousness, we may inherit eternal life. With receiving just a gift, we are granted eternal life. Titus 3:5 actually tells us that this is the only way that we can be saved, not by what we do, but through the mercy of God. It says, "Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy hath He saved us, by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost." How does Christ's righteousness cover our sin? 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, "For He hath made Him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in Him." So when we accept Christ as our Savior, our sins are transferred to Jesus, who was sinless, and we receive His righteousness. This is how we, who have sinned, are accounted righteous before God. This is the only way that we can make it to heaven. What will happen when Christ makes us righteous? Isaiah 54:14-17 says, "In righteousness thou shalt be established. Thou shalt be far from oppression, for thou shalt not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near thee. Behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against thee shall fall for thy sake. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord." So what will happen when Christ makes us righteous? We will be established. We will be free from oppression. We will be free from fear and terror, and God will protect us. When we are righteous, how do we stand before God? There is a story of a man who was in prison. And he was put into prison with the penalty of death. His life had to be taken. And unfortunately, that man had a family, a wife, children. And he had done something. He had done something accidentally. And this accidental sin or mistake that he made was going to cost him his life. But his brother came to visit him the day of his execution. And his brother was a twin. They were twin brothers. They grew up together. They looked alike. Their hair looked the same. And his brother came and saw him in the prison cell. And his brother said, "You know, my brother, I want to do something for you. I want you. You have a family. You have children. I want you to have life. I want you to have freedom. I want you to have my righteousness." So his brother said, "Let's change clothes." They were in a locked cell, in a closed cell. No one could see. And the two brothers, the twin brothers, exchanged clothes. And he who was righteous stayed in there and waited to be executed the next day, when the one who was actually guilty walked out a free man in his brother's clothes. He was able to live a life of freedom because of his brother, who took on his clothes, who took on his place in prison. You know that Christ took my place? You know that Christ took your place? Christ gave us his righteousness, and he took our sin upon him. He took our sin all the way to the cross of Calvary, where he died for our sins, so we could have his white robe of righteousness. Are you ready to accept Christ's righteousness? How will we feel when we become righteous in Christ Jesus? What will that feel like? You're going to have peace. You're going to have joy. You're going to have such happiness. And I want to ask you today, are you ready to come to Christ today? Are you ready to accept him as your personal savior? Are you ready to let him be your righteousness? He's waiting for you to come to him today and let him cover you with the white robe of his righteousness. Come to Jesus today. He's waiting for you.